doubt a win would be hugely a great confident booster for the team, and the boys have come together well. We've had a good couple of days training, and the boys are really excited and looking forward to the game against the formidable team in Georgia, and what they've achieved over the last few years is, you know, where we want to get to. And, but as you said, we've got four test matches in consecutive weeks, with the last two being our World Cup qualifiers. And so we have to look at it and, with the squad, and we have to look at how we best utilise everyone and how we manage game time for our players. And that's important because if we don't do that right, we don't want to be, you know, too dinged up by the time we get to our qualifiers, because at the end of the day, that's what this four-week campaign is going to be gauged like.
Yeah, no, I'm massively excited to be back in Canada. It's always a great experience to lift the trophy, and doing it for a second time with two different teams was awesome. You know, now I'm just hoping that there's some of the momentum that I've gotten used to with the Scarlets to the end of the season, I can hopefully, you know, bring it over to the Canadian team. You know, give a few little tips from my experiences. But after all, you know, it's all about just gelling the team, like Mark said. Giving young guys a shot as well. And our ultimate goal is the World Cup qualifiers. But you know, looking forward to this weekend's match against Georgia, and then we'll take it from there.
Yeah, it's a huge honor to be named co-captain. There's a lot of great leaders that have captained Canada in the past. But saying that, at the same time, we have a lot of leaders in the team with a lot of experience. So they take the burden off DTH and myself. So. It's not so much stepping up, it's just leading by example and saying the words that need to be said at the right moment, and really looking forward to this, the test this one.